the moon, build there, and then set it out, right? They're also planning to build a small station on the moon that is more for like observatory sort of thing, science, experiments, that sort of thing, right? And then on top of that, they have the planned man-made mission to Mars with a new engine. And then recently, other than finding the lakes on Mars that have actual water, did they find something else about Mars that was like microbial or something in nature? Like something that was not normally found on Earth, like a different type of microbial? Or was it Saturn? Something I remember hearing, like, they found like a microbe that, or a microorganism, not on Earth. Nintendo hates Mandatory. Oh God, they do. Like, you can't have anything at all. Which, take it a Dragon Age. I was kind of hoping, what was it, last year's like little teaser with Dragon Age, I was hoping we'd get something and they're like, artwork, 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 and it's like, oh no, they're not very long, they're not very far along. Oh, uh-oh. Well, I pissed something off. I feel like the next 50 years. Now that we seem to be getting back into space, which is great, I feel like life in general, like the day-to-day things might not change that much, but like the grand scope of things might be just reshaping things we know about our lives. At the presence of microbe, but not actual anything live yet. Well, Chet, have you seen that movie? I think it's called Life with Ryan Reynolds. It's a sci-fi horror movie where they come across like a microbial and then that it like slowly blows up to something more dangerous. Not saying that I want that to happen, but like, boy, that'd be interesting. Again, not saying that I want a crew to go through that horrific thing, but you know, again. God, I wish you wish rid of the webbing right there. There we go. Andromeda, they better make it their damn time. And okay, so little fact here. Okay, so we have probably sometime in April or May, depending on when Mass Effect Remaster comes out. We're doing Mass Effect 1, 2, 3. Bear with me. Bear with me. We're actually sitting down to finally play Mass Effect Andromeda. I played about 30 minutes of that game and I tapped out. Now, same thing happened with Dragon Age Inquisition. I played about 30 minutes of that. I got really pissy and I tapped out. And then years later, we decided to stream it, play it. I had a lot of fun with it. Mind shift being changed. We will be doing a franchise stream of Mass Effect. Boy, do I hope that Andromeda is decent. Like, I hear the gameplay, the combat, I should say, is good. But I did hear they also fixed, like, my face is tired. I'm hoping that's really going to be a thing. Kind of trivia question. Do you know the coldest place in the known universe? Inside Jeff Bezos' heart? Chest cavity? No? Okay. close. Okay, okay. As long as I was close, I feel a little bit better. Lads on Earth. I'm assuming that's because certain things need to have a certain temperature, so we... Well, not experimentally. There's a word I'm drawing a blank on. Not unnatural. Well, it is unnatural, but there's a, God, I'm drawing a blank on a word. Artificially. Make it cold. There we go. That's the word. English. I do occasionally use it sometimes. It's not very well. I don't know what I want from DA4. I'm done with Thetis after Dragon Age Inquisition. I know what I want for Dragon Age 4. I want
Dragon Age Origins back.
I want option to have a new character. I don't want to continue. I want a brand new character. I want the backgrounds from Origins. And you know what? I want the CRPG elements. Like, give it to me. Give it to me. Because here's the thing. You see companies like Obsidian, who took Pillars of Eternity and took it from a real-time CRPG to a turn-based RPG, CRPG similar to Divinity Original Sin. And if they could pull that shit, you know what, with EA's financial backing, they could have two sets of the game where one it's like Dragon Age Inquisition, one like frickin' Origin. They have the money. They just gotta have the time. That's what I want. One of my favorite games, I'm just kind of happy that they truly ended with the DLC. I was so upset with that DLC. I was so bummed by that. I still haven't fixed that, by the way. I can't get a workaround for that bug at all. Like, at all. And I really hope that they don't, like, try to continue. Like, I kind of want them to continue it, but my save never got, our game never got finished because of that damn bug. If you guys don't know, the final DLC for Dragon Age Inquisition has a game-breaking corrupted bug. I know the ending now because we had to look it up on YouTube as a community, but the bug for that was, and they never fixed it too, bullshit, is it's just a flip of the hat. As that DLC starts, when you go to try to interact with the portal, the like arch, nothing will happen. Like, you cannot get past it. No way to fix it. There's no console command to get past that. Nothing. It's a flip of the coin. You either get it or you don't get it. That's it. You get it, then there goes your game, dude. What's worse, there's no guarantee you won't get it a second time. So even if you try to do a whole new playthrough, there's no guarantee. And I tried take my character and going back through. I tried so many things and it wouldn't work. You think if you're gonna have a final DLC story, like it has final DLC for your game, but all of this money, think that they would have done that. Did I try blowing the game cartridge? No. Also, I didn't know this, but
that's really bad.
As a kid, we thought that worked because it seemed to work. But then your game got worse over time. You just never realized it. But to be fair, I did a lot of rentals with Blockbuster and Hastings and Hollywood Video. And so, sorry to all the kids who try to play those games and realize they were totally broken, though, because, yeah. All because I decided to blow into that damn cartridge, Dad. Oh, I remember the DLC. It's kind of like, the weird thing is there are certain games that I break games. Like, I've already broke this game, well, once. When we were playing on the PS4 back in the day. When we first playing it. I've yet to break it on PC. But if there's a way, I will sadly find it. This year, and oh, that's actually kind of, I see here, we'll be finishing on Prey. I'm looking forward to that. Because I never got around to finishing that game, thank you very much. But I have games for, they just broke. Like, really bad. Night Trap, I think another one. That broke really bad for us. Couldn't finish it. Prey. Dragon Age Inquisition. I got shit luck. Really do. Yep. The other side, but we have a key. Where's the key go? Down there. But yeah, the bug is just that archway. Like, once you, you get the wrong thing, get the wrong thing. Yeah. It sucks because the game, I started really enjoying that game. I started really, like, having a lot of fun with that game. And it's just, that sucks. Tony, hey! Morning, evening, afternoon. But yeah, this year, we're finishing Prey on the PC, damn it. We're also playing the DLC down the road. But that'll be the other half of the, also, whoever gives sub to Tony! Thank you. Wait, though, I want to see the backgrounds except from BOA come back. Yes. I really liked those backgrounds. It gave your character history. Which, not a lot of BioWare games, other than writing in like a, writing in a backstory in a D&D like Baldur's Gate situation or Icewind Dale. I don't recall any time where there was a history to your character. Excluding one game. Then again, it's been a long time since I played Jedi Empire. Well, I should say, a history or backstory that you yourself have made. Pretty easy. The solo run of the game as a warrior on Nightmare, it was, dude, that's probably why. Warrior, dude, look, here's the thing. Warrior is a really fun class to play in Inquisition, and you can break that a little too much. In like fun ways, don't get me wrong. Maybe I don't use a heavy, scary weapon. Did he, Rollin', 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 roll out. Ah, yeah. It's weird. Dragon Age 2. If they were to ever do a remake of a game. Dragon Age 2. Please. You do Dragon Age 2. Just remake that damn game. Because it's one thing to be like, okay, I'm looking at this. I have this guy right here. Right? We got Lickitung up here being a bitch. Right? We got to take him out. But I know we only have Lickitung. I can see that. I could probably see some things, but it's not going to be like, after you take out Lickitung, two more Lickitungs are just going to appear. Now deal with that. There was nothing in Dragon Age 2 that allowed you to, like, you just, it felt like you just constantly didn't know where anything was coming. But that's the thing, is the story, though. The political intrigue. They basically made Game of Thrones, but as a game. A really good, like, story. Like, it was really good. Good characters you actually really cared about. only gripe is they took Anders and they threw him away as a character. I loved him in Awakening. He was phenomenal in Awakening. Tyranny does that. As part of the game, you have Fear Conquest, where you build up what you did during that time frame, and 2X games change a lot depending on your choice. See, that's amazing. That almost feels like, it's weird. Nothing against BioWare, but it always feels a little like Obsidian comes in. And kind of does it almost a little bit better. And they always seem to do it in so much little, like, when you compare, like, the amount of time that BioWare takes compared to Obsidian. Obsidian's like, you didn't have a whole lot of time. Gotta go over here and do this. So, yeah. A good girl. Evening, afternoon, hope you have a good day. We're, just bitching about BioWare. And be honest, getting excited for Mass Effect Remaster, but we'll be doing a franchise stream of it, and we'll finally be sitting down and playing Andromeda. Oh, wait a minute, what is that noise? Oh, that'd be that right there. Hello. Now, to be fair, we were using an Odachi. However, chat has deemed from on high that the playthrough today, I'm not allowed to use that. Comes in and makes BioWare look like an indie studio sometimes. Yeah. Every RPG studio, though? I mean, kinda. Kinda what I'm hoping that Outer Worlds, I love Outer Worlds, don't get me wrong. I love Outer Worlds. However, I would like to see them, now that they're owned by Microsoft, like, let the dialogue and pillars blend in with Outer Worlds. Let those options come in. Let some organic options come in. Like, really amp up their game, right? They have the finances. Let's do it to it. I think this is the door. That is the door. We still have one DLC. Yes, that is true. We still have one DLC left. And we'll be finishing up, when that DLC comes out, we will be finishing up our evil, dumb melee playthrough of that game. And I might do one more playthrough of using actual weapons. You know, gun. Because after a while, the hammer is just real good, man. Like, we were just going around kind of breaking things with that hammer. So, careful. Shortcut. Okay, take the shortcut. I'm down for the shortcut. Funny feeling that'd be a trap. If this was Dragon Age 2, though, we would have killed him, and then like a few more would have spawned and just be like, what the hell? Our world needs more main story. Which is the main story out of Worlds, it's very short. It is. But again, Outer Worlds was the reason why I'm a little bit more forgiving is it was a budget title. Like, this is how much money they have, and they didn't go past that, and I'm okay with that. That's the thing. And also, I think I got that game for $40, which made me feel even more like, okay. Like, when I look at the, like, spectrum of a video game, and if it's like, yeah, this is like $30, $40, this is a budget title, this is all we had, I'm more lenient on it because that was their wheelhouse. That was it. But now that they're owned by Microsoft, it's like, come on. Oh, I know. The same thing is, I'm not bashing on the game. It's just more as in, you know. I don't trust that. Is there anything above us? No? Have you played the Shadowrun games? No, I haven't. You're talking about, like, the cyberpunk fantasy game, right? Really don't want to die right now? Look, I know it's, like, that's right there, but, like, I really don't want to die right now, man. I can help it. Anyone else getting trapped vibes? Yep. Ah.
Dang.
This is probably not gonna do a whole lot of damage because he's totally immune to fire damage. Okay, I need to do this. I hate this thing. I play like X Men. I think I saw his. I might be wrong, but I could have sworn I saw Zeke play a Shadowrun game not too long ago. He actually seemed to enjoy it pretty well. I imagine I have one or two of them. Not like to toot my own horn, but... might have gotten into a bundle. Oh, also, thinking of XCOM... one of these days, it may not be this year because we just kind of have too many games to get through, but I'd like to sit down and play XCOM 2 with DLC, possibly. I should have saved that. Let's get our summer child, Chad. I'm not leaving our little boy over there. Here. Do we have any new? Not a hit.
Oh, we got a new Adachi.
I can't. Okay.
Hey.
I do love the armor in this game. The armor is just, so good. All right. Looking sexy, chat. Never gave that out, three game bundles, free like 4 or 5 months ago. Secondary view. If I can't use your main, just try it. I'm gonna mark these just in case. That way we don't get rid of them accidentally. Oh, that's a hammer. Hang on. That might work. Here we go. All right, pop it. Like a pimple. I love this game. Guess we'll try this. Don't forget different stances. Oh, yeah, actually, right. Try it. Hey! Okay, well, yeah. I like that attack animation, honestly. Okay, this attack animation is the same for Neo 2. We might try spears early on and see how that goes. Let's give me the boost. Soul matching cost reduction. Wait, hold up. This actually... no? Is that a high stance? I got a buff there, and I don't know what that buff was or how I got it. Also, watch the ceilings. I have a whole lot of health. Yeah, drop dead, you little. Everspace 2 released in early access yesterday, right? Yes, it did. I was watching DJ Knight actually play it yesterday as I was finishing up the computer. And it's got 25 hours of gameplay right now. For $40, it is essentially a game. You would not be missing out if you bought it now wanting to play. It'd be a good time. I think you might be right about the armor. Oh shit. Dude, spears.
Kind of nice.
I mean, do I want my Odachi? Yeah. But this is pretty good. Also, how do I get in there? It's essentially a game. Yes. What I mean, more to the point though, is you know how people when they get into early access. Their first thought is like, man, this is expensive for the act. Not a whole lot here. There's a lot of game in Everspace 2. It's like 3 or 4 ships that you can pick from, multiple upgrades. Yeah. I saw a few people compare it to not Everspace. That's the game. To Freelancer. If you've ever played Microsoft's old, really good space game, by the way. Okay, which piece of armor is actually granting this? Heroic Raging Bolt. Is there a way to know what that is? Help? A set bonus obtained by wearing various pieces of equipment favored by Urata Nagamasa. Which information? Two pieces, damage reduction, life, close combat damage, damage reduction. Blade protection consisting of... So it's just damage reduction, like low level damage reduction. Really good low level damage reduction. Okay, did I see a Kodama? Yes. Yes, I did. No, little buddy, come to me. Come to daddy. Nope, come to daddy, damn it. I mean, Fallout 76 is still in early access. I think Fallout 76 will still be in early access. Even when we get to 2076. I still legitimately might just be like come off as a meme. But I still probably don't think it's funny. But I haven't played it recently, so you know, you never know. That might be different. Might actually be okay. Okay, we're looking through all the crystals. Nope. Only have one, so wouldn't be worth doing anything. That's true, but it is kind of impressive that it's giving me a little bit of damage reduction even with one set. Because normally, when you have set gear, they don't activate until you get that other piece. I appreciate the extra piece set up right there. I'll tell you what. Also, boss fight. It's gonna be a sexy lady in the front, isn't it? Chat. Got a lot of love in the truck. A lot of love in the truck. You're like, you can't have my booty. My booty is protected from your booty. Oh god, you're right, it's Quelog. And she can break dance! Close. I got greedy. That's a problem. Favorite multiplayer Fallout, it's not an RPG. That's the thing, is it felt like they were trying very hard to make it feel like it was supposed to be an RPG. I think that's where they made a mistake, is it's okay to market one thing, but when you try to market like, hey, it's
an RPG with your buddies,
that comes off as problematic. Just a little bit. I think if we don't get greedy, You should have it. Leave no child behind, other than the one that was chilling out on the roof. Any of my gear have Emerita recover? Bonus for absorbing Emerita. Auto recovery. No, why? There's something special to that. Oh, it's the healing buff. Bonus for, okay, so, I do want to keep this. That is, that buff is actually working out in our favor. When you pick up money, you heal. Oh! I did not know that. Did not know that was an option. Ah, so sticky. Alright, let's try this again. God. I think I got a little stuck there, chat. I got a little stuck. Where's my death counter at, by the way? Oh goody, we're 7 days away. Exactly what I want to see. The Emerita absorb buff. So that one, okay. Already on it. I think I can get her, but here's the thing, chat.
It is that time.